Blessings to you. Yes. Good morning. Good morning. Yes. Yes. When you come in, share. Good morning, Monique. Good morning, Marcy, Tamika. Blessing. Come on in. Thank you. I don't know if y'all can hear this song. I don't own the rights of it, but it's talking about the labor room. I wish you would produce this song. I love this song. Yes. This morning, we're talking about the labor room. And I'm already being blessed just even in what God has been showing me. So I'm just going to jump right on in this morning. Thank you for joining me. And, you know, hopefully I can see the comments because Facebook is doing something new. So I normally could download my recordings that I did, but now they won't let me. So I've got to go through a different platform so that I can keep them. And so what happens is your comments come to me a little slower, but I'm going to try to keep up with whatever you are saying. So I'm just thanking the Lord for what is going on. So let me share this scripture this morning. And it is, let me pull this back up. There we go. I'm reading from John 16 and 21. Just one little piece of scripture. And it is, it will be like a woman suffering the pains of labor. When her child is born, her anguish gives way to joy, for she has brought a new baby into the world. Thank you, Jesus. Now, in this portion of scripture, I want to give you a little bit of the background so I can run with what God is telling me. In this portion of scripture, Jesus has just told his disciples that he's leaving them, but that he would return. So he tells them, look, the world is going to rejoice over what's happening to me, but you're going to grieve. He said, but in just a little while, he tells them this grief is going to turn into joy. And he says, in fact, the scripture reads, you will grieve, but your grief will suddenly turn to wonderful joy. Thank you, Jesus. And then it goes into this piece of scripture that I showed today. So let me just talk to you what this pain, labor pain, this pains of labor look like. Well, you know, if you've had a baby, it's this tightening of your muscles. And it occurs, actually, you can start to have labor pains as early as you know, 4 months, but it becomes real intense and regular when you're active in labor, okay? But you also, if anybody's had children, know that there's something called false labor pains. And really, they've given it the name of Braxton Hicks. Now, it's an irregular contraction, but guess what? It is perfectly normal. This is what the Lord, it blessed me, even when you think about it. Now, as a woman, when you're going through that, that's just a pain. It's an irritant. But can I tell you what is really happening is those Braxton Hicks are necessary. Why? Because they're preparing your body for the real thing. Come on, somebody. Let me tell you what the Holy Ghost said. Some of you in the last season were having Braxton Hicks in the spirit. You were having spiritual Braxton Hicks. What did that look like? It felt like it was time for you to press. It felt like that thing that God had been promised you was ready to come. But then when you went to the labor room, they had to send you back. Why? Because it wasn't time yet. I don't know. I'm going to raise my hand on that one. How many of you have felt like that in last season? God gave you some promises. You felt the pressure and the pain, but then when you thought it was time, you did nothing come. It wasn't time. And so what the enemy of your soul tries to do is he tries to discourage you in that season so that you would just abort the mission, that you would say, oh, ain't nothing coming, so I'm not even going to look. I'm not even going to wait. I'm not even going to continue to press forward. But I just want to encourage somebody today of this. God said it was necessary because it was preparing you for the real thing. It was preparing me for the real thing. God is not a man that he should lie. He said, I'm not going to bring you into the labor room and I bring forth what I have planted in you. That's what the song was saying. So many of you have been feeling those Braxton Hicks. I just want to encourage you today. Don't get discouraged. Just because you felt the pain and the thing didn't come, didn't mean it ain't coming. You was doing, it was a test. You know, on TV, when they go that beep, this is only a test. This is only a test. That's what the Lord is saying by way of the Holy Ghost. Some of you were getting a beep. This is only a test. This is only a test. But God doesn't allow us to go through a testing if he don't plan on bringing something, if he don't plan on bringing a result of what the testing has already been doing on the inside of us. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now, let me tell you something. Now, we're talking about this labor room. So some of you in past season, the Lord said you've been feeling those Braxton Hicks. And so you've come discouraged. But I come to tell you, God said, don't get discouraged because I am going to bring from you what I have already declared. I'm not fickle. I'm not short of memory. He says, I haven't lost my train of thought. I know exactly what I said and I said what I meant. And so he said, there's coming a time where those trial runs is going to bring about the true signs of labor. Now, what's some true signs of labor? First of all, you know, when you go into labor, what starts to happen is you can have some cramping and some increased back pain. Come on, somebody. Why is that? Because the baby has now moved downward because the baby is positioning himself or herself to be able to be pushed. And so guess what? That's painful. You feel the pressure of that on pushing down on your back and you get cramps. You can't get comfortable. How many have been coming into this year where you feel like you've been feeling that the spiritual back pain? You've been feeling the weight, if you will, of carrying that thing that's on the inside of you. And when you carry in the weight on the inside of you, the enemy wants to tell you that's depression. The enemy wants to tell you to give up. But I come by way of the Holy Ghost to tell you, don't give up. You're getting close to the labor room. You're getting close to the labor room. So guess what? Because we're getting ready to push, there's going to be some increased pressure. There's going to be some increased pain. There's going to be some intensity. Now, I hear people see, and then, you know, to bless your soul. I've heard people say, well, you know, when God get ready to bring you something that, you know, it's just going to come and there's no pain and everything moves smooth. Maybe that's they lie. That ain't they lie. That ain't never been my lie. Anytime the Lord done brought something for me, I had to go through labor. I had to go through by this way. I had to go through the pressure. I had to go through the pushing. I had to go through the Braxton Hicks. That's the way I had to go. Now, maybe some of you, you know, God bless your beautiful soul. If you never had to come by this way, but some of us had to. So please stop telling the rest of us that had to go this way that we done did something wrong because we done had to go through the labor room. My stuff ain't, you know, I bless, sometimes I be like, Lord, I think I heard Joyce Myers one time. She said, you know, her husband would say, I want to quit smoking cigarettes. He stopped the next day. She said it for her was a struggle. For some of us, the birthing of what God wants to do, it ain't always just an easy push. It ain't always it can't quit. But we got to be ready to say, hello, Lord, help me do what I need to do because I don't want to miss what you have for me. And so guess what? It's okay that if you're feeling some increased pain right through here, it's okay if you got a little cramping because you're getting close to the labor. Room. I get it. So cool. Then let me tell you what else is a sign that you're about to go into labor. Fatigue. You know, I know for me, I became anemic. My children, they were just sucking a pole of life out of me. I became anemic and I could feel that fatigue. Can I tell you something, brothers and sisters? You know, when God is ready to bring somebody to you, when you right at that place, guess what happens? You can feel the fatigue. You begin to feel some fatigue. You feel the battle fatigue because it's been hard. You've been carrying this thing for a long time because it's been birthed on the inside of you. God planted the seed, but now the seed has to grow. And see, let me just put a pin right there and step here for a minute. See, you and I couldn't have even been ready to bring forth nothing. We couldn't have been even ready to go to the labor room had we not first been intimate. intimate. We had to be intimate to be able to get impregnated. So because you was intimate with God, you allowed him to put something on the inside of you. So now if he put it on the inside of you, he said, I will bring forth what I have placed in you. Thank you, Jesus. And so guess what? You're going to feel a little fatigued. Because why? The enemy of your soul is trying to make you abort the mission. He is trying to bring forth. He don't want that what's in you to bring forth life. He don't want it to come forth. He wants to make you feel fatigued. He wants to make you feel depressed. He wants you to feel like God ain't hearing me. God ain't helping me. These crampings ain't going away. This stuff, this back pain ain't going away. When can I get comfortable? I can't sleep. I can't eat. Everything is irritating me. God, what is going on? He said, you get ready for the labor room. Thank you, Jesus. And then you start a nesting instinct. You start to get ready your room. You start to get ready the baby's room. You start to get ready for to bring forth this thing, right? Well, I can tell you right now, God says some of you right now in the nesting instinct, you have been pulling back on some stuff. You know, and I'm going to tell you how you know you're in the nesting instinct, because you're closer to home. And home doesn't mean physically in your house, but you've been turning more inward. You've been like the stuff that you used to do and all the stuff you used to run around and do. You've been feeling a sense that you need to settle down. You've been feeling a sense that you need to be still. Why? Because you got to get some stuff ready and you want to hear what needs to be done. So you moving in. So some people ain't going to understand that. Some of your friends or folks that you normally been kicking with, they're going to think you acting funny. They're going to think you being funny. Why? Because you needed to pull back, because you've got this nested instinct, because God is trying to tell you, I'm getting something ready to be birthed in you. So everybody can't come in the labor room, because you know what? Everybody ain't coming. All your friends and all your homies, everybody not even invited to come into the labor room. And so you've been kind of getting still, because you know you're getting ready to go push out what God has called for you to push out. And so he said, that's all right. You get into that place, be quiet and be still. You know, I can feel it even coming into this year. I could tell I got kind of quiet. I mean, yes, I'm busy, but it's like the Lord just said, settle down, Joy. He just said, nestle in. He said, because I got something to talk to you about. And so I've been kind of quiet, just settling in, letting him work on what he about ready to birth something new in me in this season. And that's what he said. He's been talking to you, but now you really know you're getting close because your water breaking. Some of y'all water is about to break. Your water is about to break. You are about to find yourself in the labor room. And let me tell you something, all of these things, right? See, you know, when the water break, thank you, Jesus. When your water break, I get a deal. So when your water break, this is what happens. You got to go. Because right after the water break, guess what? The labor pains are about to come. These ain't about to be no false ones. These are the real ones. They coming. And you getting ready to take yourself in to the hospital or to the place where you about to give birth, right? Let me tell you something. All of these things, you know, if you've walked through pregnancy or even watched somebody walk through pregnancy, some of this stuff is painful. And it makes many women ask the question, Lord, why did I want to have this baby? You know what? Many of you have been pressing and walking and pushing for this thing that God has told you about to come for. And many of you say, Lord, why? I don't know if I want this baby no more. Lord, I don't even know if I want the dream you told me no more. I don't know if I want the vision you gave me no more. It's too hard to wait. This waiting is taking too long. I don't know if I want it no longer. I don't know if I could wait any longer. But I come by way of the Holy Ghost to say what the scripture said. But God says the anguish is giving way to joy because she brought a new baby into the world. What does the Holy Ghost say? He said, the anguish you felt in past season for carrying what he put inside of you is about to be removed. He's about to release the joy. Why? Because you're about to birth that thing that he said you was going to birth. You're about to see it come to life. You're about to see what he said that you could do. You're about to do it. It's about to be live. It's going to be bigger than what you thought it was going to be. And let me tell you how the Lord talked to me. Thank you, Jesus. This is March, right? This is the third month. He said, in this month, for many of you, it represents the third trimester. By way of the Holy Ghost, it represents the third trimester. For many of you, get ready to birth a thing. Get ready to birth a thing. Get ready to see what God has said is coming. It's going to come. And then he said, for many of you, because we're in this 2020, this season of doubling, he said, watch what you see. It's going to be bigger than what you thought. Let me tell you what a niece of mine several years ago, maybe about 5 years ago, she had a dream, a vision. She shared it to me. It was about me. But God recently brought that vision back to me. And he gave it to me like it was like he showed it to me in the first place. And in the vision, I was getting ready to give birth to twins. Now, one of the babies, the second part of the vision was one of the babies was, if you remember, baby Huey, that big old huge baby. She said it was a newborn baby, but it looked like baby Huey. And everybody kept saying, oh, this baby is so old. This baby is so old. And she said, no, this is a newborn. Come on, somebody. Let me tell you by way of the Holy Ghost. God is saying for some of you today, he said that because you have walked in past seasons obediently doing what he told you to do, that thing that he's about to birth in the labor room, that thing that he's about to birth in you, guess what? Not only is it coming out big. Not only is it coming out healthy, but it's coming out big. It's coming out bigger. This is the season of the double. You about to have that baby going to be a double baby. Ha ha. It's going to be a big baby. It was the twins. And then the second part of the vision she had was the baby was huge. Look for this vision to be bigger than you even thought it was going to be. Look for it to be much bigger than you thought. Bigger, bigger, bigger. It's going to be new, but God said it's going to come out already big. Thank you, Jesus. Let me tell you something else about the labor room. Oh, Rabasata. See, many of us, and I think I shared this before, you know, when you are getting close to when you're about to have a baby, you have a baby shower. So you invite your friends and your family. You tell them to come celebrate with you because you're about to have this baby. And guess what? Let's say you went in labor. And after you had your shower, well, guess what you're not going to do when you get to the labor room? You ain't going to be upset that somebody didn't come to your shower. The people that didn't come to your shower, you ain't going to be upset about it. Why? Because your focus has now shifted to the labor room. You got to come in and shift to the labor room. What the Holy Ghost is saying, don't worry about who disappointed you in last season. Evidently, they wasn't supposed to be part of the birth that's about to happen in you. Don't be upset if somebody left you. Don't be upset if they talked about you. Don't be upset about what happened in past season, because guess what it didn't do? It didn't stop the birth of the thing that God is about to bring in out of you. He said they talked about you, they lied on you. It don't matter, because he said, I'm still going to meet you in the labor room. Come on, somebody. It is the time and the season. God said, it's the time for the push. 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 He said, it is the time for the push. Because see, when you go in the labor room, everybody ain't in the labor room. The doctor's in the labor room. You know, you may have your mother in the labor room, or you may have somebody in the labor room coaching you. You're going to have, you know, the father in the labor room. And guess what's going to happen? Y'all close everybody else out. Even though people are outside waiting to hear what's going to happen, everybody can't be in the labor room. Why? Because everybody can't be there, because you don't want the situation and the environment to be tainted. It needs to be sterile. God said, sometimes I got you in these places where you feel you isolated because I need the place to be sterile. Come on, somebody. I don't need all this infection. I don't need people's wrong words. I don't need people's wrong actions. I don't need all of that coming, because I need this place to be a place that's ready to bring forth what I have in you. He said, so don't be upset if they don't show up. They weren't supposed to be in there. He said, those that are supposed to be there will be there. See, that mother that's in there, or that woman that's in there, she represents by way of like that midwife. God said, I'm going to make sure you got somebody that can walk with you, that's going to be a midwife, that's going to help birth this thing out of you. Whatever it is, God said, I'm going to make sure it's birthed out of you. And then the husband man is there. Who is the husband man? Well, God himself says, I am in the room with you. Why? Because I am going to make sure that what comes out, it comes out the way I want it to. He said, and in the doctor, guess what? You know, Holy Ghost is our doctor. Jesus is our doctor. Guess what? You know, we got the triune God in the labor room with us, bringing forth what needs to come out of us. And so we got to trust him for the process. We got to trust that he gonna do what he said he gonna do. Because if he said it, guess what? He is going to do it. Amen. So this is what the labor room looks like. And guess what? You listen to the instructions. Because see, many times you're ready to push, but you got to wait for the right time to push. Because if you push too soon, something might be off. So you got to wait and listen. So even though you might be feeling the pains to push, listen to the Holy Ghost tell you when it's time to push. And when he says it's time to push, then that's when we push. We don't push before then. We push when he say push. What did I gave you the scripture again? It said, it will be like a woman suffering the pains of labor. When a child is born, her anguish gives way to joy because she has brought a new baby into the world. Let me just tell you this. See, you know why the anguish is gone? Because she is now somebody new. Her identity has been changed. Before she had that first child, she wasn't a mother. She was who she was, but she wasn't a mother. She might have been a wife, but she hadn't taken this new identity. I hear the Lord say this. Thank you, Jesus. He said, when I birthed this thing out of you, you now have a new name because I have birthed something new in you. I am taking you to the next level because you allowed me to birth in you this new thing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You allow him to birth a new thing. See, just like before Paul became, you know, when he was Saul, then he became Paul. He went from one person to another. He had a change in identity. God says, the thing that I'm birthing in you is about to change your identity. It's about to shift you to a new place. It's about to shift something new in you. And guess what? Be okay that the people that used to know you used to know the old you. They don't know. They haven't been introduced yet to the new you. So you be okay with showing them the new you when you bring forth that which you have in you. Oh, my God, my God, my God. The labor room. God says it is time for you to prepare yourself for the labor room. Prepare yourself to listen and hear for the signs that it's time. Be prepared to listen. Because like I said, you're going to have those signs of labor. Some of that fatigue, guess what? Because you know what? My fatigue left after I gave birth. After I gave birth to my daughter, because I used to be like, Lord, they just sucking the life out of me. But as soon as I gave birth, it's like my energy restored. And I hear the Lord say, when you give birth to this thing, whatever it is, whether it's a ministry, it's a business, whatever he's got on the inside of you that he's ready to give birth to, he said, watch all of the signs of labor move away. Why? Because you are no longer in labor. You have now birthed a thing. Thank you, Jesus. See, when you birth a thing, guess what happened? The signs of labor disperse. You no longer have the fatigue. You no longer have the cramps. No longer the back pain. No longer needing the, you know, your water done already broke. You done already broke the thing. So I just declare that as you prepare, you're going to get the strength and the power to walk through the labor. But on the other side of the labor, I hear that your kusa. You're on the other side of the labor, you're going to be able to see your strength renewed. That's why the scripture said your grief is short, but then comes the joy. See, some of you, this time of the laboring has even been, it's been sucking on your joy, but I just declare the Lord say, I'm bringing the joy back. I'm bringing your joy back, and I'm bringing it back double fold in the name of Jesus. He said, I'm bringing your joy back, bringing your joy back. He said, because see, some of us, we discouraged. Why? Because we're in the waiting process. We don't like waiting. But I come by way of the Holy Ghost to say, that's okay, because even in the waiting season, God is doing a thing. Like I said earlier, you know, you have those false labor praise, those Braxton Hicks. Don't even despise those, because God says they're getting you ready for the real. They teaching you how to respond, how to breathe through. Because I don't know, you know, when I had my child, I took the lessons on how to breathe, right? Because I didn't have no medicine. I went through that way, but they taught me how to breathe. So when the pain would come, I knew how to breathe through. Guess what? I stopped focusing on everybody. I was like, I got to breathe right through here. And I hear Holy Ghost saying, you, when you're going through, learn how to breathe. What's breathe? You just breathing in the air. You just breathing in more of the Holy Ghost. Fill me up afresh and anew by way of the Holy Ghost. I'm breathing in some newness. I'm breathing in some strength. I'm breathing in some encouragement. I'm breathing in what I need. Oh, Rabasa, I'm breathing. So you got to learn how to breathe through. And then when the pain go away, you relax for a minute, but you can't get too relaxed because the next one is about to come quick. And then when it comes, you just learn to breathe through, breathe through, breathe through, breathe through, breathe through. Why? Because of the fact that it is going to bring the thing that God got for you. Because yes, you're right, Jessica. Birthing is a hard thing. It's a hard thing. It's a hard thing. Some people have long labor. Some people have short labor. But let me tell you something, because people used to tell me, oh, you only was in labor for 4 hours, so your labor wasn't worse than mine because mine was 12 hours. But my doctor said that's not true. She said the fact is you had to do double time, so your body had to be prepared in less time, so your pain was actually worse. Because my tractions wasn't even, they was doing like this, they was coming on top of each other. I like, Lord Jesus, what happened? But guess what? It don't matter whether it was 12 hours or whether it's 4 days, whatever the Lord has called for you to the time for it, to birth the thing, you know that he gonna give you the strength to be able to make it through. He gonna give you the power to be able to get to the other side, because he already said, what I have brought you into the labor room, what I have determined is gonna come from you, I'm gonna bring it forth. It is coming forth, Jessica. It is coming forth by way of the Holy Ghost. He said, I'm not putting anything in you that I'm not going to birth out. He said, I have promised you some stuff, and don't let the enemy tell you that it's not coming, because what's happening is you've been feeling some of the fatigue. He said, but that's all right, because the fatigue is just letting you know that the baby is dropping low and getting ready to be birthed. Thank you, G. He said, just keep breathing through. Keep breathing through it. He said, because if you know that I'm going to bring it about. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we love you today. We grateful today. I just want to encourage you. Don't let what you see determine what God has said about you. He has told you, I'm inviting you into the labor room. And in the labor room, it gets messy in the labor room too. Can I tell you that? When you give birth, it ain't clean. It's kind of gross. It gets a little messy. So guess what? That's why everybody can't be there. So don't be upset that everybody ain't in the labor room with you. Because guess what's happening? It's messy in there. Some of y'all going through deliverance. Thank you, G. You know, you might be throwing up. You can't breathe and all kind of stuff. Your body functions doing all kind of stuff. And you can't see everybody because everybody ain't going to protect that. Woo, Jesus. Everybody can't come in the labor room with you, because everybody is not going to keep you covered while you're going through your labor. Some people going to want to, flash you and expose you. But God said, I'm only letting those in the labor room that can hold you and keep you safe. So don't worry, because in the labor room, it gets messy. But what comes out, what comes later, oh my God, it is worth it. It is worth it. So God said, don't get discouraged. Don't get discouraged that the things that he's doing in you might not look perfect yet. That's all right. He's birthing a good thing in you. He's bringing about a good thing from you. And he said, treat it like a live birth when it gets here. What do I mean by that? When you treat something like a live birth, when you have a baby, you're going to feed it, you're going to nurture it, you're going to talk to it, you're going to do what the baby needs. You're going to give it what it needs. God said, when I birth this thing in you, you invest in it. Put your time in it. Put your prayers behind it. Seek him on what to do about it and come and bring it back to him. Just like, Hannah said, I want a son, and she brought it back. Take it, make what birth in you is like a Samuel. Take it back to God and say, now God, you use it. Oh Jesus, it's time for the labor room. It's time for the labor room. It's time for the labor room. Again, I say, this is March. God showed me real clear, for many, March is like the third trimester. This is a spiritual trimester for many. He said, and because this is a season of doubling, many of you he's given more than one promise to. And so it looked like nothing was coming. He said, but I'm going to bring everything that I said from you. So look for some twin births. Thank you, Jesus. Look for some twin births to come about in this season. You're going to have a book published on this side, and you have a show go on this side. Or you're going to, get a job here, and you're going to get a contract there. Stuff just going to start happening doubles. Stuff just going to start happening doubles. Doubles, 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 doubles. Stuff is going to start happening in doubles. And now who is this for? I go back to what I said in the beginning. You couldn't get pregnant without intimacy. Those that have been intimate with God, those that have allowed God to do some work on the inside of them by way of the Holy Spirit, he left a deposit. Thank you, Jesus. He left a deposit. And the deposit is about to bring forth and birth in your life. Thank you, Jesus. 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 I want to pray for us today. I feel that thing. For those that came in later, you can go back and watch the replay because I just believe this will bless you. And this is what I'm talking about this whole month is just this thing about the labor room. Because next week I'm talking about the labor room. You are the carriers of warriors. Because see, God said, I got some on the inside, but now I'm going to talk to you about what he showed me, what some of y'all were carrying. He said, some of y'all carrying warriors. Oh my God, my God, my God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let me just say this before I pray. Part of what's going to happen in you as you change in when you go through labor, as I started to say, if you weren't a mother before, you never had the name of mother. God said, I'm making some spiritual mothers and daddies in this season. What does that look like? That means he's giving you the charge over something that he wants you to nurture. He's giving you the charge over something. It may not be a person. It might be an entity. He might be saying, I'm going to make you the mother over this church. I'm going to make you the father over this business. I'm going to make you a mother, a father in a spiritual sense that you now are responsible for something. But you couldn't get that until something was birthed in you. So whatever God is going to birth in you, he says he is now changing your name. And guess what? Everybody ain't going to like you. Everybody not happy because you are now becoming a something new. They liked you the way you used to be. They liked you who they was because, see, they liked you in their dysfunction and your dysfunction. Why? Because then they could feel like they was better than you. Come on, somebody. Come on. But God said, not so, not so. I'm changing you. And you go ahead and keep walking in what I'm about to change you into. Father, we come right now in the name of Jesus and say thank you. God, we thank you because you are bringing us into the labor room. And you have already said that what you have planted in us, you will bring to pass. You will bring it to pass. You're going to bring it to pass. Thank you, Jesus. And that's right. I thank you, Lord God, because you showed me that this is going to be a season. Many folks are going to see two things born. They're going to see twins bought in this 2020, in this doubling time. Father, I give you praise right now in the name of Jesus. Now, Father, I pray you give us the strength because many of us have gotten weak and discouraged waiting on the time for that thing to be born. We've gotten discouraged because maybe we've had those Braxton Hicks and they fooled us into thinking the thing was coming and then it didn't. And then the enemy of our soul tried to discourage us and say, see, God ain't promised you this, but I come by way of the Holy Ghost and to declare that the devil is a liar because God already made you a promise and he's not a man that he should lie. He told you he was going to do a thing. He's going to do that thing. He's going to birth in you exactly all that he said he was going to birth in you. Not some, not partial, but all of it. And so, Father, I thank you as you prepare us as your children to be ready to receive that which you have for us. Father, I thank you. You're going to strengthen us through the cramps and the back pains because that just lets us know that the baby is dropping and it's coming time for it to pass through and to come forth. Lord God, we thank you that even in the season where we might have felt fatigued, we thank you that you are giving us renewed strength. I declare renewed strength over your people right now in the name of Jesus. Father, and even for the nestling season we find ourselves in, Father, I pray right now that you would help your sons and daughters to be able to understand that there's a reason you are calling them to step back and step aside because you want them to be able to hear clearly from you. And then, Father, the water's about to break. Father, we thank you for those that the water is about to break. God, give them the strength to be able to come into the labor room. Oh, Rabasata, Ikianda, Seke, oh, Robobo, Seke, and that is Sikiundre, Basana, Arebesianda, Rabasa. Because, Father, your promise is this. You said the anguish gives way to joy because why? We brought a new baby into this world. I thank you for every ministry that's about to be birthed in the name of Jesus. I thank you for every creative idea that's about to be birthed in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for every business, every entrepreneur. I declare, Lord God, you're about to birth abundance in them in the name of Jesus. Where they was looking for one blessing, I thank you, you're about to release two blessings in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for every author on here in the name of Jesus. I thank you that this is the season and the time that you are rising up the anointing of the scribe in the name of Jesus. Where they thought they had one book, I declare they got two books. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Father God, that you're going to help even those, Lord, in raising families. Father, I thank you that sons and daughters are going to rise up, natural sons and daughters are going to rise up in families in this season, Lord God. And I thank you for you have, we have birthed them into this world. But Lord God, we thank you now for saving them, setting them free, filling them with the Holy Spirit, and setting them on fire. Thank you for anointing us to become the fiery ones. We're going to walk in the fire. Father, I declare fire in our eyes, fire in our hands, fire in our voice. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus for all that you are releasing on the inside of us. Father, I thank you because not only, Lord God, are we going to come through the labor, but when we get to the other side, Father, I thank you, we're going to be new. You've given us a new name because we've never birthed this thing before. I thank you, Lord God, because even now I see that there are spiritual gifts on the inside of your children. Some of them have been dormant. That's what you're about to birth in this new season. Some prophets are about to rise up in the name of Jesus. Some apostles are about to step fully into the apostleship. Father, the evangelists are rising up. The preacher is rising up. Father, by the way of the fire, Lord God, we are coming out of the labor room with the holding the birth in our hand. We're coming out of the labor room holding that which you have declared in us, and we're going to be joyful. I speak a double portion of joy be released in this season over your people. Father, many have been discouraged that they've been waiting. But Father, even as we're waiting for the birth, give us a release right now of your joy. Father, I thank you. Lord God, I thank you for the new beginnings that you are giving to people. You told me, and I believe you said you have graced me to release new beginnings. So by way of the Holy Ghost right now, in the name of Jesus, I release new beginnings over everybody that's listening. Father, those that thought they were stagnant, I declare a new door is opening for you. I declare a new way is opening for you. I declare that everything God has said about you and for you is opening for you. You will not die. You will not decrease. You will not, the thing that God had for you, you will not be aborted. Your mission will not be aborted. You will walk in the fullness of it. God declares you got a new name, a new identity, and a new purpose. I declare you're going to walk in it. No longer looking back. No longer returning back to where you came from. But I declare you're moving forward in the things of God, in the anointing of God. And Father, we say thank you. We give you praise. We give you honor. In Jesus' name, we pray this prayer. Amen. Whew. And amen and amen. God is just so, so good. Oh, my goodness. I am so hot. I can feel it. My eyes are just so red. I can feel the fire. I feel like my whole body is on fire. And I said, God, that's because of what he is doing right now for you. Don't let the enemy talk you out of what God is doing. Amen. Amen. I just want to give one little plug and then I'm going to let you go. My new, my registration is open now for the next session of the Eagle Soar Mentoring Program. All I could tell you is it's been a blessing for the women that are already in there. I only have 5 slots left. We do a one-on-one at the beginning and I give you an action plan, and these action plans, not no 1 or 2 liners. The ladies could tell you they've been like 30 pages of detailed stuff to walk you through every part of your life. And then there's an actual online portion. We do mentoring. So there's a lot there. And I believe it's worth the $250. If you just put a $25 deposit down, and you can pay, I am fine with payment plans. I will work with you. I don't want you to say, well, I don't have all of the money, be the reason you don't receive the blessing. So pray about it and ask the Lord if he wants you to go through this. And if he does, I am willing to work with you. However, so you could just inbox me or leave me a message. But again, I just want, I wanted to offer that. And I have 5 spaces left. So again, ladies, gentlemen, whoever listened, if this blessed you, share this. And remember, God says, look for something this month. Don't wait. Look for something this month. Even if you don't birth in this month, God says, prepare yourself. Prepare yourself because he's about to bring something out of you. You know, many of you follow me. I'm the flower lady and I've been talking about blooming because the Lord been talking to me for that for a while. God is blooming on the inside of us. He's about to bring some stuff out of us that we could not even thought would manifest. So don't underestimate. See, you looking here and God's saying, but I'm coming here. I'm coming higher than you can think. My God, my God. That's right, Brenna. Keep looking. And God says you ain't gonna have to look long because he's going to provide you with some steps and he's gonna make it plain for you to see that you are walking in the right direction. And let me just say this to y'all before I go. Many of you, the enemy tries to tell you you're not positioned right. If you are in his word, if you are in his presence, you are positioned right. The enemy wants to get you out of position. Don't let him trick you out of the position. Keep holding in position because he is faithful. He's going to show you. See, we often think we're out of position because we don't see the results yet. We don't see the results yet. God said, no. The waiting time. When you go through pregnancy, he said, how you know you're pregnant? You can feel it. You know, you can start to see yourself swole. See yourself swole in the spirit. Begin to see that God is swelling you up, that thing in you is being birthed. It is growing. And as it's growing on the inside of you, it's going to come out. It's going to come out. Okay, y'all. Oh, y'all going to get started again. It's swelling on the inside of you. I just need for somebody to hear that today. It is swelling on the inside of you. And you're getting impatient. That's how you know it's swelling on the inside of you, because you're ready to push, but it's not time yet. It's not time yet, but the baby's growing. The baby is growing. The baby is growing. Sapphire, the baby is growing. Sherry, the baby is growing. Tamika, the baby is growing. Keisha, the baby is growing. Marcy, the baby is growing. The baby is growing. So don't let the enemy tell you that it's not. It's growing. It's growing. That thing is growing. So keep nurturing it, even as you wait for it to come out. What do I mean? Let me give you a practical thing. If you're a writer and God to put a book in you, it ain't birthed yet. And so you don't know what to do. He said, sit down and write. Just write, because that's what's coming out of the inside of you. And before you know it, you're going to look around and guess what? That book going to be ready to be produced. That's one of your babies. Maybe God done told you to do something in terms of a business that's a creative side that may be, you know, artistic or something. And it's not ready to launch yet. But he said, but you're nurturing it behind the scene. You're feeding that baby. And eventually, guess what? It's going to be birth. He says, so keep feeding because the baby is swelling. The baby is swelling. And you're going to the labor room soon. God bless. God bless. So until next time, as I always say, we're going to keep praying until we see the mountains move. Have a great day.